morning. Welcome to yoga. My name is Kristel. This is Hatha yoga, slow and stretchy, nothing crazy, user friendly. We're going to start by sitting in a comfortable cross-legged position. So most of you, that's easy pose, ankles crossed. I'm going to do half lotus because I can. Okay, then you want to lengthen your spine. Just imagine a gold cord lifting you up. You're going to open your chest. We're going to begin by breathing deeply in through your nose, into your belly. Expand the belly, the diaphragm, the chest and lungs, and then breathe out through either your nose or your mouth. Close your eyes. Full, deep, slow breath. Yoga is union of body, mind, and spirit through your breath. Okay, you're going to gently open the eyes. You're going to bring your arms to the side. Deep breath in, lifting. And then bringing your arms down slowly. Just feel the space around you, breathing out. Okay, lifting. Time clasping your fingers, pushing up and release, slowly coming down. One more time, lift. This time right hand to left thigh, left hand behind you on the mat. Lift your spine, press on the thigh. Left hand to right thigh, right hand behind you. Lift, press, breathe. Okay, you're going to bring your hands to the front and walk your fingers forward, just whatever your body allows. Maybe a little bit, that's fine. Maybe more. Going to walk your hands behind you, fingers facing forward on the mat, feet hip distance. You're going to press into your hands and feet, lift your hips, look up. Arms and legs, either here or you can straighten them, either one. Then we're going to cross the ankles and come to all fours. Okay, shoulder over wrist, hip over knee, hands flat, no space. Feet either flat or tucked, cat, cow. You're going to breathe out, arching the spine. Breathe in, dipping the spine. And continue at your own pace. Try to feel each vertebra. It's a very simple pose, but it's very effective for loosening the spine. Okay, Okay, now we're going to flatten the feet. We're going to make circles with our head and our hips, moving everything around like a big cat. And then opposite direction. And then we're going to shake your head, your shoulders, your hips. Kind of loosen everything, shake. Okay, then we're gonna take our hips out to the right and make circles behind you to the side, to the front. And then opposite direction, breathing. Okay, then we're gonna widen the knees, cross the big toes, sit back on your legs as far back as you can. Extend the arms, bring your forehead to the ground or close to it. Child pose, take this anytime you need to release your low back. Walk your arms over to the left, breathe into your right side. And then other side. Okay, come back to all fours, bring your knees closer together, come up to your knees. Palms face forward on your thighs, looking up for camel. You can either stay here or you can hold your heels. Okay, back to all fours. You're gonna take your right arm under your left arm. Come down on the shoulder, extend the left arm. And come back up, other side, left under right, coming down, extend. All fours, engage your core, extend your right arm, left leg, and either hold it or reach across. Switch, left arm, right leg. Back to all fours. You're gonna tuck your feet under, lift your hips, lower your head, and just begin to pedal the feet, alternate pressing the heels down. And then press both heels towards the ground, drop your head, rotate your inner elbows forward, find your dog and breathe. Now you can either stay in dog or you can lower your hips to upward dog and go back and forth. Just make sure you lengthen your low back when you do a back dip. And make sure the weight is in the whole palm and fingers, not just your wrists, breathing. Okay, everybody come back to dog. You're gonna walk your feet to your hands, forward fold, and just hang, breathing into your hamstrings. Fingertips on the mat, bending the knees to a squat. Come back up, keep your knees slightly bent as you unroll your spine, vertebra by vertebra. Then rolling your shoulders. Okay, widening your stance, clasping your hands behind your back, lift your arms, lift your chest, open your heart. For all the computer people, you should do this throughout the day because we're all getting very hunchy. Okay, wider. You're gonna fold over, lift your arms. Okay, release the hands, right hand to left ankle, lift the left arm, breathe, and then other side. Drop the arms, walk your feet in a little bit, and come up with a big arm circle. Backstroke. Arm swing, shoulder level, side to side. And then hip level, tapping the back of the body. Okay, figure eights. We're going to draw an eight with your hips. So right hip forward and back. Left hip forward and back. You can always do figure eights with your eyes or your head. It helps link up the brain whenever you cross the body. And then the easy brain gym, cross crawls, opposite hand, opposite knee, look up to the left with your eyes. And then look up to the right with your eyes. Okay, you're gonna put your palms face forward on your low back, bend your knees, stick out your butt, scoop forward and up the wave. And then we'll do super brain yoga. Left hand squeeze the right earlobe, right hand squeeze the left earlobe, tip of the tongue, roof of the mouth. 14 squats. This has been proven to help with autism and ADHD and any kind of learning disability. It's on YouTube. It's created by an energy healer. And here we get our blessing. Now we're going to wake up the body, a little qigong, cup the hands, stimulate all the acupuncture points, and then pound the knot in your shoulder, pound, okay, other side. Another way to wake up the body is with peppermint oil. If you just put a little bit on the back of your neck, it vitalizes you. Okay, front of the body. Back of the body. Low back and kidneys. And then sides of your legs. Then your brain, either fingertips or loose fists. And
rag doll, just kind of. Okay, front of the mat, feet hip distance. Spread your toes, connect your heels like a triangle. Open the chest, palms face at the heart. Deep breath in, lift, either straight up, or you can add a slight back bend. Forward fold, swan dive, just hang. Breathe into those hamstrings. Fingertips on the mat, right foot back to a lunge, engage your core. Come up to your knee and lift your arms. You can always put the back knee on the mat. On the mat, left foot back to right, body is straight, plank or push-ups or modified plank. Remember, if your wrists bother you, you can always do this. We'll try to hold it for a couple of minutes. If you need a break, child pose or downward dog. Okay, we're going to put our knees on the mat, keep the elbows close, lower the chest and just hover above the ground. Slide the chest forward, lift your hands and feet, baby cobra. Okay, hands on the mat, pushing up to upward dog. Pelvis and legs off the ground, lengthen your low back. And then tuck your feet under, lift your hips, lower your head, find your dog. And then walk your feet to your hands. Do you want to go undercover? No? Okay. I had one class, they just wanted to be in the pouring rain. Just let me know. Okay, other side. Deep breath in, lift. Forward fold. This is winter in Hawaii. Rain and a light jacket. Fingertips on the mat. Left foot back to a lunge. Engage your core. Come up to your knee. Lift your arms. On the mat, right foot back to plank. We're going to do side plank. So either the right knee goes down or the leg stays straight. You can rotate and lift. Other side, either knee down, rotate, or straight rotate. You choose. Breathing. Okay, back to plank. can either put your knees down or just keep your elbows close and lower. Hover above the ground. Slide forward. Put your forearms on the ground. Sphinx. Always kind of, it's called Hastabandha. You want to like connect the hands, not like that, but more like pressing. Okay, and then if you want to try bow, don't force. You can grab your ankles or not, and lift or not. Remember, every day is different, every body is different, so always honor where you're at and don't force. Remember, use your fitness ball at home to do your back bends. It's an easy way to do it. Just lay backwards over it. Okay, hands on the mat, pushing up to upward dog. Pelvis and legs off the ground. Lengthen that low back. And then tuck your feet under, lift your hips, find your dog. Breathing. Okay, we're gonna kick our right knee in the air between our arms. Straight back up. Then the knee, let the foot fall to the side, opening up your groin, your psoas. Try not to torque the body. And then kick that knee in between the hands, foot to one side. Back leg flat, foot flat. Try to keep the weight off, so this is no. You just kind of walk forward and breathe into that hip, groin area. Just allow those muscles to gently release. Use your breath, full deep breaths. Hands on the mat, push the chest up, grab the right foot, put it between your hands. Push that heel forward and just lean over it. Okay, back to all fours. Back to downward dog, tuck your feet under, lift your hips, lower your head. Then you're going to kick your left knee forward, straight back up. Bend the knee, let the foot fall to the side. Then kick the knee in between the hands, foot to one side, back leg flat, foot flat. And walking forward. And breathe. So at home, you could always read a book, hang out. Like in yin yoga, they have you hold this for 5 to 7 minutes, which either feels wonderful or horrible, depending on your body. So just use your breath and try to relax into it. Enjoy the pose. On the mat, push the chest up, grab the left foot, put it between your hands, push that heel forward and lean over. Okay, back to all fours, back's downward dog. And now you're going to bring your right foot in between your hands and come up to standing.
You're going to have your left foot 45 degrees, your heel intersects middle of the back foot, hip bones forward. Engage your core. Bend your knee so you just see the big toe. Try to keep it aligned. Open the chest. Lift the arms. Warrior one, breathing. And warrior two, right arm forward, left arm back. Arms are parallel. Looking over that front hand. Reverse. Lift the right arm up, left hand on the back leg. And then straighten your front leg. Put your left hand on your hip. Keep your hip tucked under. Bring your right hand either here or here. You're going to open your chest to the side. Lift the arm. Triangle, breathing. Come back up, face both feet forward, drop over, and then just walk out as far as you can and just hang out for a minute, just a nice easy inversion. Breathing. On the mat. If you can, bend your right knee, walk over to the right. If you cannot, you can just lean over to the right. Your choice. Okay, then come back up. And the other knee, walk over to the left. Come back up, lock your feet together. Unroll the spine. Other side, left foot forward, right foot back, same thing, heel intersects, middle of back foot, the hip bones forward, engage your core, bend your knee, open your chest, lift your arms, and breathe. Left arm forward, right arm back, arms are parallel, looking over that front hand. Left arm up, right hand on the back leg. Straighten the front leg. Put your right hand on your hip. Left hand on your thigh or shin. Open your chest to the side. Lift the arm and breathe. Come back up, walk your feet together and face the ocean. Okay, we're going to do tree pose. So you're going to ground the left foot. You can do it on your mat or the cement, whatever's easier. Find a focal point, something that's not moving. Put your right heel to your left ankle. Now you can either stay here or bring it above or below your knee, not on your knee joint. Then your arms can go wherever.
ready, you can come down. You're having a good balance, stay as long as you want, because every day is different and every side is different. Other side, same thing, ground, focus, breathe, engage your core, lift. One more balance. You're going to ground your left foot, grab your right ankle. Lift your left arm. And then lean forward, lift your arm and your leg. Other side, whenever you're ready, same thing. Just make sure you ground that foot, engage your core. Okay, we're going to come down to a squat.
Have two couples here. Very nice. Okay, you're gonna sit back, extend the legs, pull the flesh out so you feel your sit bones. You're gonna put your right foot over your left leg, lift your chest, right hand behind you on the mat. You're gonna either hug your knee or elbow on the outside and breathe. All twists help to massage the internal organs and aid with elimination. Legs, tighten, left over right, left hand behind you on the mat, hug or elbow, and breathe. Full deep breath. Your left foot on your inner thigh. If you have tight hamstrings, have your towel ready for your foot. Otherwise, deep breath in, lift. Fold from your low back. Let your head and arms drop. Grab your foot or grab your towel. And with each out breath, just allow that hamstring to lengthen. And your low back to release little by little. And you're going to put your elbow on the inside of the knee. Take your left arm to the side. You're going to lift that arm up. And then take it behind you on the mat. Lift your hips. Switch legs. same thing. Deep breath in, lift. And fold. Breathing. Elbow on the inside of the knee, right arm to the side. And right hand behind you on the mat. Lift. Come back down. Face the ocean. Take your legs out to the sides. Lift your hips up a little bit, move them forward, and then push your legs out a little bit. And then just walk forward, just however much you can. Remember, you can use this one to watch your movie. Just put a few cushions here and hang out. It's your daily stretches that add up. Do not wait for a yoga mat. You know, it's nice to do an hour, but 10, 15 minutes a day really makes a difference. Okay, then you're gonna cup your inner thighs. Up the muscle, you just loosen it a little. Okay, then you're going to face the front, put your feet together. You can either press down on your inner thighs or put your hands behind you and push them down. There's a nice restorative pose where you put blocks or bolsters under your knees and a bolster behind your back. And you just lay back and hang out for 5 minutes. Restorative yoga, yin yoga, those are all nice ones. Okay, you're gonna grab either toes or big toes, and you're gonna lift either to the side or to the front. And when you roll back, it's fine. Let's all roll back and rock side to side. Happy baby. Okay, then you're going to put your feet on the mat. Knees are bent. I'm just going to move my mat so you can hear me. We'll do our low back stretch. Okay, you're going to lift your hips. Move them to the right, put them down. Hug your knees, let your knees fall to the left. Keep your right shoulder on the ground. Put your left hand on your thigh. You can do this before you get out of bed in the morning. Feet on the ground. This time lift your hips a little bit to the left. Put them down. Hug your knees. Let your knees fall to the right. Look to the left. On the mat, center the hips. You're going to put your palms face down. You're going to press into your hands and feet, lift your hips, clasp your hands under your back, and then just sort of rock and tuck the shoulders under. This is called bridge. breathing. Okay, release the shoulders, release the hands, lower the hips, hug the knees. Just rock a little. Okay, feet on the mat. You're going to put your right foot on your left thigh. You're going to reach through, one hand in the center, one on the outside, and either grab your shin or your hamstring. Pull your knee towards you. This is for your hips. If you want to add the hamstring, you're going to straighten the leg. Either grab the calf, or you can use your towel like a yoga strap. Everybody should do this stretch every day. Hip and hamstrings, tight from walking, standing, everything we do pretty much. Full deep breaths. Choices are either you can do a leg stretch like this, or you can just have your legs up the wall. Pretend there's a wall here, nice easy inversion, or you could do shoulder stand if you know how. You just have to make sure if you do shoulder stand you have space behind your neck. So whatever you want for the next couple minutes. Put our palms face up under our thighs. We're going to slowly lower the legs. As you lower your legs, you're going to lift your chest and head off the ground. You're going to arch, put the top of the head back on the ground, and just breathe into your throat and thyroid, fish pose. Lay flat. Reach your arms over your head and just stretch in opposite directions like you're being pulled on the rack. Then lift your arms straight up.
let your right arm fall to the left. Press that shoulder open. And then other side. Bring your arms to the sides. You're going to squeeze your hands, your arms, your shoulders. Tighten those muscles. Squeeze all the tension out. Squeeze, 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 and release. Then you're going to tighten your hips, thighs, and feet. Squeeze, 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 and then release. Roll your head side to side. Crunch up your face in a tight little ball, squeeze. And then stick out your tongue, open your eyes, go ah. If you want, you can rub your palms together and place them over your eyes to create a little heat. Rejuvenate and relax the eye socket. And then you're going to put your palms face up by your sides. Close your eyes. Make sure you're comfortable. If you want to put your towel over your eyes or under your head. I'm just going to lead you through a brief visualization, and then you're going to relax to the sounds of the ocean and the birds. So you just want to imagine gold ball of light at the crown of the head. You're going to allow that healing light to pour into the body, into every cell, every muscle, organ, system, beginning with the cells of the brain. Allow that liquid golden healing light to pour into the cells of the brain, rejuvenating, repairing, flushing out toxins. And you're going to bring that liquid golden light into your throat and thyroid, to your shoulders, your arms, your hands, your fingers, all the joints, flushing out toxins. Then you're going to bring that liquid golden healing light into your lungs, rejuvenating, repairing, healing, flushing out toxins, making your lungs strong, resilient. And then into the heart. Into the emotional body of the heart. Healing any past hurt. Repairing all the tissue, rejuvenating the muscles. Bringing that liquid golden healing light into your organs. Your liver, gallbladder, to your spleen and pancreas, your kidneys, your adrenals, to your rib cage, your stomach, and then into your colon, your large and small intestine. Bringing that liquid golden healing light into your hips, pelvis, into your reproductive organs, rejuvenating, healing, repairing, flushing out toxins. And then in, let it pour into your thighs, your knees, repairing your knees, healing
calves, your ankles, your feet, your toes. And then bringing that liquid golden light to the base of the spine and bringing it up the spine, vertebra by vertebra. If there's any particular place you need extra healing, just take that light there. Next few minutes while we get gently rained on, hopefully just gently, you can relax. If it starts to pour, you're welcome to move. And of course there's a rainbow. Just let the rain cleanse. Whenever you're ready, no rush. You're gonna pull your knees to your chest. Gently rock. Roll to the right side. And then just slowly push yourself up whenever you're ready. Your eyes closed, you're going to take a nice deep breath, hold it, and then just breathe out anything you don't need, bringing your hands to your heart. Just think about what you're grateful for in this moment in Hawaii by the ocean. And then let's send light, love, and healing to our planet, to the oceans, to the trees, to the animals, to the bees, to each other. Bringing your hands to your third eye, thumb knuckles on your forehead. The divine in me honors the divine in you. Namaste. Thank you so much. I think I cut it a little short just because of the rain, but it was nice, wasn't it? Oh, look.
Yeah.
Oh, we're so lucky.